You want a cheap alternative to a glass bed surface? I tried this one for you. Yeah, I got this spring steel sheet from a company that is called Ender-3. It comes from AliExpress and it is coming for about 20 euros. You can get the link from the description. It is spring steel and it is magnetic, so you can attach it to the bed of your printer with magnets. Let's get started with the review then.
Let's do the unboxing now. So as you can see, the actually unboxing is a bit of a big word. The packaging is pretty basic and there is also a crack here in the corner, but let's see. Comes out of it. It looks like it's been opened, probably for inspection from customs. So let's see. Okay, we get our flexible spring steel sheet. It's flat and shiny. And then there is the PEI with a 3M sticker on the back, which is also good. Let's see for something else. Couple of more things, so we will read what it says afterwards. So that's it for the unboxing. It looks pretty okay, so it's flat, shiny, and looks good. Now we're going to attach the PEI sheet onto our new bed, and I recommend to clean it thoroughly from fingerprints or any other kind of manufacturing residues you might have. So just wipe it with a lint-free cloth and make sure that it's nice and clean. And then when you are done, you have to grab your PEI sheet, and then I see that mine is cut quite, let's say, roughly on one of the sides, and actually on two of the sides probably. So I will leave that side for the front, and we proceed by peeling out a small portion of the 3M sticker to the side here. It seems I'm getting a good grip out of it, so I'm going to continue like this. Don't be too concerned about damaging the surface here, because there is a protective cover on top, so don't be shy, and you can be a bit strong with pushing it down. And there we are, and just lying it flat and fine. So squeezing out all the remaining hair trapped beneath the sticker. And there you go. So I want to do a clean work here out of that. So I'm going to turn it over and put it on my cutting mat. And then I'm going to take this knife here and just run it and here we are. Don't forget that we have a protective layer on top of this, so we will have to peel it off before we can actually start printing over it. And you have that golden color on top of it. You can see some of the lines, but I'm not too concerned. I mean, it's nice and sticky. So here we are.
Then we have to level up the corners again. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to preheat both the bed and the hot end, because you want everything to be expanded to the real conditions of use. So this is going to take a while. I'm going to crank up a bit of the temperature on the hot end up to 215, because that is more similar to what I'm normally using. So I'm going to make it a bit hotter than needed, and then we wait, and then we will have the firmware do the magic of the corner leveling. So now everything is nice and hot, so we go into the prepare menu, and then we do an auto ohm. We wait the machine to do the ohming sequence. You can hear that the only motor that is making any noise is the Z-axis motor, and that's because I didn't install dampers on that one. If you want to know how to install dampers on a machine with press fit pulleys, link in the description to the video I made. Now that the ohming sequence is done, we go again into the prepare menu, and inside prepare there is, you scroll down up to level corners, and then we click level corners, and then it goes to the first corner, and we go with our paper sheet. I'm going to do the leveling. I'm using a very thin sheet of paper, so I'm using it folded over.
After having leveled the bed, I go for a test print, and I'm doing a lithophane. I would not classify it as a success, but anyway, this is not the purpose of the video today. And the nice thing is that then you can take it out, and the print comes off the bed, it comes loose with a very satisfying pop. Here is another experiment. I was experimenting a bit with Cura 3 supports, and you can see that basically the print comes off the pad without any effort at all, and also the skirt comes away with basically peels off without any force needed.
All in all, I'm very satisfied with this surface. It printed effortlessly and very good. The surface finish is fine, and the prints come out very nicely with no force at all. On top of this, it is magnetic, so my next project is going to use magnets to attach it to the bed of my Ender 3. And this is it for now. It's a thumbs up for me. If you want to subscribe, please do it. And otherwise, until next time.